Laudetur Jesus Christus. Praised be Jesus Christ. Welcome to this live broadcast of the celebration of Mass on the solemnity of the Epiphany of the Lord, presided over by Pope Francis. My name is Devin Watkins, and I will be providing the English translations and commentary for today's liturgy. I hope that it will be discreet and help you as we pray together during this solemn liturgy. On behalf of Vatican Media, I would like to welcome all of you who are joining us today through various Vatican News channels. A warm welcome to those joining us through CBS News, Salt and Light TV, Catholic Faith Network, Shalom World TV, EWTN TV, Telecare TV, Catholic TV, and to all of you joining us on the radio in many parts of the world or through various internet sources. We see Pope Francis processing down the aisle with the many cardinals and bishops and ministers who will serve at today's Mass. Today celebrates the solemnity of the Epiphany. It always falls on January 6th, but this year it falls on Sunday. But in most years when it does not, local bishops' conferences can decide to celebrate Epiphany on the nearest Sunday, usually between January 2nd and January 8th. Francis, who has just come forward and venerated the child Jesus, kissed him on the knee. He's placed on a little throne, beautiful and ornate with candles surrounding it, in front of the altar of the confession. And he reverences the child Jesus with incense. We're celebrating today. Epiphany means manifestation. In regular secular language, we can say we had an epiphany, meaning a sudden realization, revelation, or kind of an aha moment. In theological language, epiphany is similar. We are celebrating the revelation of Jesus Christ, or his manifestation, to the whole world. And now he prepares for Mass, incensing the altar and the cross. As Epiphany can mean manifestation, In theological language, it's very similar. We're celebrating the revelation of Jesus Christ, or his manifestation to the world. And the feast encompasses three mysteries. First, we reflect on the adoration of the Christ child by the Magi, which is the gospel we will hear today. Secondly, Jesus' baptism in the Jordan, where all four gospels testify that the Spirit came down on him in the form of a dove, and a voice from heaven declared him to be the Son of God. And third, Jesus performed his first sign in John's gospel at the wedding of Cana. All these three are ways in which the gospels show us how God revealed to him, revealed himself to us in Jesus. Epiphany marks the liturgical high point for the Advent and Christmas season. Jesus was born in silence in Bethlehem, but now he is made manifest and known to the world.
In nomine Patris et Filii et Spiritus Sancti.
Amen.
Pax vobis.
Et cum spiritu tuo.
Fratres, agnoscamus peccata nostra, ut aptissimus ad sacra mysteria celebrant.
Pope Francis invites us to reflect on our sins.
Confiteor Deo
omnipotente, et vobis fratres, qui ad peccaminibus, cogitatione, verbo, opere, omissione, mea culpa,
mea
massima culpa, ideo peccor, beata Maria, sempre Virgine, omnes angelos et santos, et vos fratres, orare pro me, ad Dominum Deum nostrum.
Miserator nostri, omnipotens Deus, et dimissis peccatis nostris, producat nos ad vitam eternam.
Amen.
Amen.
Oremos. Deus, qui odarna die, unigenito in tuo gentibus te la luce revelasti.
O God, who on this day revealed your only begotten Son to the nations by the guidance of a star, grant in your mercy that we, who know you already by faith, may be brought to behold the beauty of your sublime glory. Our Lord Jesus Christ, your Son, who lives and reigns with you in the unity of the Holy Spirit, one God, forever and ever. And now we begin the Liturgy of the Word. The first reading is from the book of the prophet Isaiah, chapter 60, verse 1 through 6.
A reading from the prophet Isaiah. Arise, shine out, Jerusalem, for your light has come. The glory of the Lord is rising on you. Though night still covers the earth and darkness the peoples, above you the Lord now rises, and above you his glory appears. The nations come to your light, and kings to your dawning brightness. Lift up your eyes and look round. All are assembling and coming towards you. Your sons from far away, and daughters being tenderly carried. At this sight, you will grow radiant, your heart throbbing and full, since the riches of the sea will flow to you. The wealth of the nations come to you. Camels and throngs will cover you, and dromedaries of Midian and Ephah. Everyone in Sheba will come, bringing gold and incense, and singing the praise of the Lord.
Verbum Domini.
Shall fall prostrate before you, O Lord. Second reading is from the letter of St. Paul to the Ephesians, chapter 3. It will be read in Spanish.
Lectura de la carta del apóstol San Pablo a los Efesios. Hermanos, habéis oído hablar de la distribución de la gracia de Dios que se me ha dado en favor de vosotros, los gentiles.
You have probably heard how I have been entrusted by God with the grace he meant for you, and that it was by revelation that I was given the knowledge of the mystery,
como ha sido revelado ahora por el Espíritu a sus santos apóstoles y profetas,
to his holy apostles
que
and prophets,
los
was unknown to any men in past generations.
Del mismo cuerpo y partícipes de la misma promesa
it means that pagans
Jesucristo
now share the same inheritance, that they are parts of the same body, and that the promise was made to them in Christ Jesus through the gospel. As it rose, and have come to do the Lord homage. Blesses the deacon who will read the gospel.
Dominus vobiscum.
Et cum spiritu tuum.
Lectio Sancti Evangelii secundum Matteum.
Gloria tibi, Domine.
A reading from the Holy Gospel according to Matthew.
Cum natus esset Iesus in Bethlehem Judae, in diebus Herodis regis, ecce magi ab oriente venerunt.
After Jesus had been born at Bethlehem in Judea, during the reign of King Herod, some wise men came to Jerusalem from the east. Where is the infant king of the Jews? They asked. We saw his star as it rose, and have come to do him homage. When King Herod heard this, he was perturbed, and so was the whole of Jerusalem. He called together all the chief priests and the scribes of the people, and inquired of them where the Christ was to be born. At Bethlehem in Judah, they told him, for this is what the prophet wrote, and you, Bethlehem, in the land of Judah, you are by no means least among the leaders of Judah, for out of you will come a leader who will shepherd my people Israel.
Diligenter didici dabeis tempus tele, quae apparuit eis, et mitens illos in Bethlehem dixit.
Then Herod summoned the wise men to see him privately. He asked them the exact date on which the star had appeared, and sent them on to Bethlehem. Go and find out all about this child, he said, and when you have found him, let me know, so that I too may go and do him homage. Having listened to what the king had to say, they set out, and there in front of them was the star they had seen rising. It went forward and halted over the place where the child was. The sight of the star filled them with delight, and going into the house, they saw the child with his mother Mary, and falling to their knees, they did him homage. Then opening their treasures, they offered him gifts of gold and frankincense and myrrh. But they were warned in a dream not to go back to Herod, and return to their own country by a different way.
Verbum Domini.
Deacon and the ministers process with the book of the Gospels, and they bring it back to Pope Francis, who will bless us with the book of the Gospels. Assembly gathered in St. Peter's Basilica, and kisses the Gospel again. The deacon brings the book of the Gospels to the little throne in front of the altar, where the child Jesus is laid, and he opens the book, reminding us that God, the Word, was made flesh in Jesus. And now we will hear the announcement of Easter and the movable feast.
No veritis, fratres carissimi, quod onuente Dei misericordia, sicut de nativitate,
no, dear brethren, that as we have rejoiced at the nativity of our Lord Jesus Christ, so by leave of God's mercy, we announce to you also the joy of the resurrection, who is our Savior.
Gaudium vobis annunciamus. Die sexta marti erit dies cinerum, et initium
Iuni Sacrati will fall Ash Wednesday, in the beginning of the fast of the most sacred Lenten season.
Die una et vicesima aprilis Sanctum Pascha Domini nostri Jesu.
On the 21st day of April, you will celebrate with joy Easter Day, the Paschal Feast of our Lord Jesus Christ.
Dietrice mamma mei, erit ascensio Domini nostri Jesu.
On the 30th day of May will be the Ascension of our Lord Jesus Christ.
Festum Pentecoste.
On the 9th day of June, the Feast of Pentecost.
Festum Sanctissimi Corporis et Sanguinis Christi.
On the 20th day of June, the Feast of the Most Holy Body and Blood of Christ.
Die prima decembris, Dominica prima adventus, Domini nostri Jesu Christi.
On the first day of December, the first Sunday of Advent of our Lord Jesus Christ, to whom is honor and glory forever and ever. Just listen to the announcement of Easter and the movable feast, which in modern times seems odd because we follow a solar calendar. But in the past, whenever calendars were not common, the announcement of Easter clearly had the function of giving the date and feast dependent on the date of Easter. And now Pope Francis
Epifania
will begin his homily.
La parola indica la manifestazione del Signore, il quale, come dice San Paolo nella seconda lettura, si rivela a tutte le genti, rappresentante oggi dai magi.
Epiphany. This word indicates the manifestation of the Lord, who, as St. Paul tells us in the second reading, makes himself known to all the nations, today represented by the Magi. In this way, we see revealed the glory of a God who has come for everyone. Every nation, language, and people is welcomed and loved by Him. It is symbolized by the light which penetrates and illumines all things.
Nel Vangelo è narrato un via vai attorno al palazzo.
Yet if our God makes Himself known for everyone, it is even more surprising how He does so. The Gospel speaks of a hum of activity around the palace of King Herod once Jesus appears as a king. The Magi ask, "Where is the child who has been born King of the Jews?" They will find him, but not where they thought. Not in the royal palace of Jerusalem, but in the humble abode of Bethlehem.
Del censimento di tutta la terra ai tempi dell'imperatore Augusto e del governatore Quirino. Ma nessuno dei potenti di allora.
The Gospel spoke of the census of the entire world taken in the days of the Emperor Augustus, when Quirinius was governor. But none of the great men of that time realized that the King of History was being born in their own time. Again, when Jesus, some 30 years of age, made himself known publicly, preceded by John the Baptist, the Gospel once more solemnly situates the event, listing all the magnates of the time, the great secular and spiritual powers, Tiberius Caesar, Pontius Pilate, Herod, Philip, Lysanias, the high priests Annas and Caiaphas. And it concludes by saying that at that time, the word of God came to John, the son of Zechariah, in the wilderness. To none of the magnates, but but to a man who had withdrawn to the desert. Here is the surprise. God does not need the spotlights of the world to make himself known.
Potremmo pensare sarebbe stato meglio se la stella di Gesù fosse apparsa a Roma.
When we listen to that list of distinguished personages, we might be tempted to turn the spotlight on them. We might think that it would have been better had the star of Jesus appeared in Rome on the Palatine Hill, where Augustus ruled over the world. Then the whole empire would immediately have become Christian. Or if it had shone on the palace of Herod, he might have done good rather than evil. But God's light does not shine on those who shine with their own light. God proposes himself. He does not impose himself. He illumines. He does not blind. It is always very tempting to confuse God's light with the lights of the world. How many times have we pursued the seductive lights of power and celebrity, convinced that we are rendering good service to the gospel? By doing so, have we not turned the spotlight on the wrong place because God was not there? His kindly light shines forth in humble love. How many times, too, have we as a church attempted to shine with our own light, yet we are not the sun of humanity?
La Chiesa è il Mysterium Lune, il Signore è la luce del mondo.
We are the moon that, despite its shadows, reflects the true light, which is the Lord. He is the light of the world, him, not us.
Si ricorda che la luce divina non impedisce alle tenebre e alle nebbie fitte di ricoprire la terra.
The light of God shines on those who receive it. Isaiah, in the first reading, tells us that that light does not prevent the darkness and the thick clouds from covering the earth, but shines forth on those prepared to accept it. And so the prophet addresses a challenging summit to everyone. Arise, shine. We need to arise, to get up from our own sedentary lives and prepare for a journey. Otherwise, we stand still, like the scribes that Herod consulted. They knew very well where the Messiah was born, but they did not move.
E poi bisogna rivestirsi di Dio, che è la luce, ogni giorno.
We also need to shine, to be clothed in God who is light, day by day, until we are fully clothed in Jesus. Yet to be clothed in God who, like the light, is simple, we must first put aside our pretentious robes. Otherwise, we will be like Herod, who preferred the earthly lights of success and power to the divine light.
Invece realizzano la profezia, si alzano per essere rivestiti di luce.
The Magi instead fulfill the prophecy. They arise and shine and are clothed in light. They alone see the star in the heavens, not the scribes, nor Herod, nor any of the inhabitants of Jerusalem.
C'è da prendere una via alternativa.
In order to find Jesus, we also need to take a different route, to follow a different path, his path, the path of humble love. And we have to persevere. Today's Gospel ends by saying that the Magi, after encountering Jesus, left for their own country by another road. Another road, different from that of Herod. An alternative route than that of the world, like the road taken by those who surround Jesus at Christmas, Mary and Joseph, shepherds. Like the Magi, they left home and became pilgrims on the paths of God. For only those who leave behind their worldly attachments and undertake a journey find the mystery of God.
Vale anche per noi. Non basta sapere dove Gesù è nato, come gli scrivi.
This holds true for us too. It is not enough to know where Jesus was born, as the scribes did, if we do not go there. It is not enough to know that Jesus was born, like Herod, if we do not encounter him. When his place becomes our place, when his time becomes our time, when his person becomes our life, then the prophecies come to fulfillment in us. Then Jesus is born within us. He becomes the living God for me. Today, brothers and sisters, we are asked to imitate the Magi. They do not debate. No, they set out. They do not stop to look, but enter the house of Jesus. They do not put themselves at the center, but bow down before the one who is the center. They do not remain glued to their plans, but are prepared to take other routes. Their actions reveal a close contact with the Lord, a radical openness to Him, a total engagement with Him. With Him, they use the language of love, the same language that Jesus, though an infant, already speaks. Instead, the Magi go to the Lord not to receive, but to give. Let us ask ourselves this question. At Christmas, did we bring gifts to Jesus for His party? Or did we only exchange gifts among ourselves? If we went to the Lord empty-handed, today we can remedy that. The gospel, in some sense, gives us a little gift list: gold, frankincense, and myrrh. Gold, the most precious of metals, reminds us God has to be granted the first place. He has to be worshipped. But to do that, we need to remove ourselves from the first place and to recognize our neediness, the fact that we are not self-sufficient. Then there's frankincense, which symbolizes a relationship with the Lord. Prayer, which like incense, rises up to God. Just as incense must burn in order to yield its fragrance, so too in prayer, we need to burn a little of our time to spend it with the Lord. Not just in words, but also by our actions. We see this in the myrrh, the ointment that would be lovingly used to wrap the body of Jesus taken down from the cross. The Lord is pleased when we care for bodies racked by suffering, the flesh of the vulnerable, of those left behind, of those who can only receive without being able to give anything material in return. Precious in the eyes of God is mercy shown to those who have nothing to give back. Gratuitousness. In this Christmas season now drawing to a close, let us not miss the opportunity to offer a precious gift to our King, who came to us not in worldly pomp, but in the luminous poverty of Bethlehem. If we can do this, His light will shine upon us. We just listened to Pope Francis's homily, and now we are invited to take a moment to reflect on his words. In his homily, Pope Francis said that Epiphany indicates the manifestation of the Lord, which is symbolized by light. He said the way God reveals himself is surprising. The Pope said God did not reveal himself to the powerful of the earth and become the center of attention. The surprise is that Jesus was born in a manger in humble Bethlehem, not on the heights of glorious Rome. And now we pray the Creed.
Fratelli e figli carissimi, attratti dalla luce che splende a Betlemme, vogliamo lo sguardo al Signore, datore di ogni bene. Adoriamo la sua presenza e invochiamo la sua bontà.
Prayer of the faithful. Dear brothers and sisters, drawn by the light that shone at Bethlehem, we turn our gaze to the Lord, giver of every gift. Let us adore his presence, beseech his goodness.
Oremus pro sumo pontifice et omnibus episcopis.
Let us pray for the Pope and all the Church's bishops. We pray in Chinese. May God, who loves every person, send them to proclaim the truth to all people, fill them with his Spirit, and protect them from all worldly thinking.
Oremus pro legislatoribus.
We pray for
Bóg,
lawmakers in Polish.
Bóg, kieruje ku dobru. Niech oświeca ich decyzje. Otwiera ich
na
posłuszeństwo prawdzie.
Inspire their decisions, open them to obedience to the truth, and prepare them to serve the dignity of every person.
Oremus pro Christianis, qui persecutionis patiuntur.
We pray for persecuted
Elohim,
Christians in Hebrew.
Asher ne manut ha adam menachemet toto, ishmorna et emunatam shlema, yechazek otam beet mifchan.
May God, who is consoled by our faithfulness, keep their faith intact, strengthen them in trials, and never let them draw back in the face of adversity.
Oremus pro omnibus scientiae deditis.
We pray for scientists.
Deus, que se revela quantos o procuram, os atraiam com sua beleza, que com sua sabedoria,
God, who reveals himself to those who seek him, attract them by his beauty, guide them with his wisdom, and free them from prejudice and ideologies.
Oremus pro peccatoribus.
We pray for sinners in Swahili.
Ambaye afurahi kifo cha mdhambi. Aguse nyoyo zao kwa neema yake.
May God, who does not rejoice in the death of the sinner, touch their hearts with his grace, transform their lives, and console them with the joy of forgiveness.
O Padre, che con la luce della stella hai guidato i santi magi all'incontro con Gesù.
O Father, who by the light of the star led the magi to encounter Jesus, grant our prayer and guide our journey with the strength of your Holy Spirit. Through Christ our Lord. Liturgy of the Word is concluded, and we begin the Liturgy of the Eucharist. Forward with the gifts. great men, Pope Francis. Sacrifice of the Mass. Is made from a single block of marble that comes from the Forum of Nerva in Rome, from the ancient Roman Empire. Francis blesses the incense and prepares it so that he may bless the gifts, bread and wine, and be blessed himself.
Orate fratres ut meum, ad est un sacrificio, acceptabile fiat apo Deum Patrem omnipotente.
Suscipi ad Dominus sacrificium de manibus tuis, ad laurem et gloriam nomini sui, ad utilitatem corpore nostram, totiusque ecclesiae sue sante.
Ecclesiae tue, quae sumus Domine, dona propitius in tue, quibus non iam aurum
tuus, on these gifts of your church, in which are offered not now not gold or frankincense or myrrh, but he who by them is proclaimed, sacrificed and received, Jesus Christ.
Amen.
Domino hobiscum,
et tuo spirito
tuo, sursum corda,
abemus ad Dominum.
Gracias hagamus Domino Dio nostro.
Dignum et justum est.
Vere dignum et justum est, tecune salutare, nos tibi semper et ubique gratias agere, Domine Sancte Pater omnipotens Aeterne Deus, qui ipsum in Christo salutis nostre mysterium, hodie ad lumen gentium revelat, et con insubstantia nostre mortalitatis apparvit, nova nos immortalitatis gloria reparat. Et ideo con angelis et arcangelis, con tronis et dominationi, con che omnia militia excelestis exercido, Himnum gloriae tua et canimus sine fine dicentes. Dicitur clementissime Pater, per Iesum Christum, Filium Tuum, Dominum Nostrum, supplices rogamus ad petimus, et acceptabilis, et benedicas, et una, et munera, et santa sacrificia illibata, in primis quae tibi offerimus pro Ecclesia tua Santa Catholica, quam pacificare, custodire, adunare, et regere degneris, tot orbe terrarum, una con me indigno famulo tuo, quen ecclesiae tue prees evoluisti, et omnibus orthodoxis, asque catholice et apostolice fidei cultoribus.
Memento Domine famulorum famularum quae tuarum. Et omnium circumstantium quorum tibi fides cognita esset nota devotio, pro quibus tibi offerimus, vel qui tibi offerunt hoc sacrificium laudis, pro se suisque omnibus, pro redemptione animarum suarum, pro spe salutis et incolumnitate sue, tibi qui reddunt vota sua eterno Deo vivo et vero.
Communicantes et diem sacratissimum celebrantes, quo unigenitus tuus in tua tecum gloria coeternus, in veritate carnis nostre, visibiliter corporalis apparuit. Sed et memoriam venerantes, in primis gloriose semper virginis Mariae, genitricis eius den Dei et Domini nostri Iesu Christi. Sete beati Iosef, eius dem Virginis Ponsi. Et beatorum apostolorum, ac martyrum tuorum. Petri et Pauli, André, Iacobi, Ioannis, Tome, Iacobi, Filippi, Bartolomei, Mattei, Simonis et Taddei, Lini, Cleti, Clementis, Sisti, Corneli, Cipriani, Laurenti, Crisogoni, Ioannis et Pauli, Cosme et Damiani, et omnium sanctorum tuorum, quorum meritis precibusque concedas, ut in omnibus protectionis tue, muniamur auxilio.
Anquisitur oblatione in servitutis nostre, sedecunte familiae tue, quesum domine ut placatus accipias, diesque nostros in tua pace disponas, atquam aeternis amationem nos eripi, et in electorum tuorum iuba rege numerari. Quam oblationem tu Deus in omnibus quesumus benedictam adscriptam ratam rationabilem acceptabilemque facere digneris, ut nobis corpus et sanguis fiat electissimi filii tui, Domini nostri Iesu Christi, qui pride quam pater etur accepit panem in santas ad venerabile manus suas, et elevatis oculis in celum a te, Deum Patrem Suum Omnipotentem, tibi gratias agens, benedixit, fregit, dedique discipulis suis, dicens, accipite et manducate ex hoc omnes. Hoc est enim corpus meum, quod pro vobis tradetur. Similmodo, post mancenatum est, accipiens et uc peclarum calicem in santas ac venerabiles manus suas. Item tibi gratias agens, benedixit, dedique discipulis suis, dicens. Accipite et vivite ex eo omnes. Hic est enim calix sanguinis mei, novi et eterni testamenti, qui pro vobis et pro multis effundetur in remissionem peccatorum. Hoc facite in meam commemoratione.
Mysterium fidei.
Et memores, Domine, nos servi tui, sed plebs tua santa, eius in Christi fili tui, Domini nostri, tam beate passioni, nec non et ab inferi resurrectioni, sed et in gloriosa resurrectione, offerimus preclare maiestati tue, et tuis donis sagratis, hostiam pura, hostiam santa, hostiam immaculata, Panem Sanctum, vita eterna, et calicem salutis perpetue.
supra quae propitia sereno vulto respicere digneris, et te accepta bene, sicquat accepta bene dignatus est, munera pueri tui justi Abel, et sacrificium patriarche nostre Abrae, et quod tibi otulis sumus sacerdus tu Melchisedec, sanctum sacrificium immaculata nostra. Supplices te rogamus, omnipotens Deus, iube perferri per manus santi angeli tui in sublime altare tuum, in conspectu divine maestatis tue, ut quod ex hac altaris purificatione sacrosanctum fili tui corpus et sanguinem subserimus, omni benedictione et gratia repleamus.
Memento etiam Domine, famulorum famularumque tuarum, qui nost precesterunt cum signo fidei et dormiunt in somno pacis. Ipsis Domine, et omnibus in Christo quiescentibus, loculum refrigeri, lucis et pacis, ut indulgiast, deprecamur.
Nobis quoque peccatoribus famulis tuis, de multitudine miserationum tuarum sperantibus, partem aliquam et societatem donare dinieris, cum tui sanctis apostolis et martiribus, cum Ioanne, Stefano, Mattia, Barnaba, Ignazio, Alexandro, Marcellino, Petro, Felicitate, Perpetua, Agata, Lucia, Agnete, Cecilia, Anastasia, et omnibus sanctis tuis. Intra quorum nos consortium non estimator meriti, sed venie quesumus largitor admitte, per Christum Dominum nostrum.
Per quenit omnia Domine semper bona creas, sanctificas, vivificas, benedicis et prestas nobis.
Per ipsum et cum ipso et in ipso, esti video Patri omnipotenti, in unitate Spiritus Sancti, omnis honor et gloria per omnia saecula saeculorum.
Precepti salutabili moniti e divina istituzione formati audemus dicere. Da propitius patiam in diebus nostri, ut ope misericordiae tue adiuti, et a peccato simus semper liberi, et ab omni perturbatione securi, spectantes beata ans fem, et adentum salvatoris nostri Iesu Christi. Domine Iesu Christe, qui dixisti apostolis tuis, pacem relinquo vobis, pacem meam do vobis. Ne respicias peccata nostra, sed fidem ecclesiae Tue, e anche, secondo volontate in Tua, pacificare e coordinare digneris, che vive e regna in secola seculorum.
Amen.
Pax Domini, sit semper vobiscum.
Et cum spiritu tuo.
Offerte vobis pacem.
Pope Francis invites us to exchange a sign of peace with those around us. And we invite you to do so also if you are joining us on the various media, if you're at home, wherever you may be.
Ecce agnus Dei, ecce quitoris peccata mundi. Beati qui ad cenam agni vocati sunt.
Domine non sum dignus, ut intre subtectum meum, sed cantum dic verbo, et sanabitur anima mea.
As Pope Francis consumes the body and blood of our Lord, this Eucharist, we are all invited to participate spiritually, as we already are, in this sacrifice of the Mass.
Thank you.
now throughout the Basilica of St. Peter to bring the many thousands of people who were there to communion.
Oh,
as the Magi once did, we also bow down on bended knee before the great mystery that occurs at the Mass. Jesus, God, God the Son, made man, and present in the Eucharist and in the Word. And like the Magi, we can reflect on their actions with Saint Leo the Great, who an ancient sermon of his was read today at Matins, and he shows that in the adoration of the Magi, the beginnings of the Christian faith. He writes, "Let the full number of the nations now take their place in the family of the patriarchs. Let the children of the promise now receive the blessing in the seed of Abraham." And we pray with both.
Celesti lumine quesum, o Domine, sempre et ubique nos preveni, ut mysterium cuius non participes,
et evoluisti, always and everywhere, that we may perceive with clear sight and revere with true affection the mystery in which you have willed us to participate. We prepare ourselves to receive Pope Francis' blessing, which is not just for those present.
Dominus vobiscum.
Et tu spiritu tuo.
Inclinate vos ad benedictionem.
Deus, qui vos de tenebris vocabit in admirabile luminum sum, suam vobis benedictionem benignus infundat, et corda vestra fides per caritate stabiliat.
Amen.
Et quia Christum sequimini confidenter, qui odie mundo apparuit lux relucens in tenebris, facet vos lucem esse fratribus vestris.
Amen.
Quate nos peregrinatione per acta perveniatis ad Deum, quem magis stella previa quesierunt, et gaudium magno lucem de luce, Christum Dominum invenerunt.
Amen.
Et benedictio Dei omnipotentis, Patris, et Filii, et Spiritus Sancti, descenda super vos et maniat semper.
Amen.
Iter missa est.
As Pope Francis processes out, he pauses to venerate Our Lady, which is a statue placed next to the altar of the confession.
Thank you.
joyous chants, Pope Francis goes and back to the altar to venerate it before he processes out. We listen to the ancient hymn, O Come All You Faithful. Processes out at the end of this Mass. We come to the end of this live broadcast of the celebration of Mass on the Epiphany of the Lord. We invite all of you to visit us on Vatican News web portal, on our Facebook page, on Instagram, and our Twitter account, where you will find a summary of this liturgy and Pope Francis's homily. It's already up. And you can also find coverage of other Vatican and world news there on our Vatican News web portal. We thank you again, all of you who are joining us on CBS News, Salt and Light TV, Catholic Faith Network, Shalom World TV, EWTN TV, Telecare TV, Catholic TV, and all the various Vatican News channels. My name is Devin Watkins, and it has been a pleasure to serve you. We also invite you to join us shortly, where Pope Francis will pray the Angelus Prayer. Laudetur Jesus Christus. Praised be Jesus Christ. Thank you.